All right, this is simple interest, and what simple interest is the interest off of only the principal. That's it. There's no compounding going on here. So the way the formula works is the simple interest is just the simple interest rate times the total investment times the number of years, and this is also called your principal. Okay? So the interest rate that we have is a 5%, and we always write it as a decimal. So we just divide that by 100, it'll tell you what the decimal is. Principal is 5,000, and then we're going to do it for 1 year. So if you multiply these together, so 0.05 times 5,000, I didn't multiply by 1 because it's only 1, gives us 250, and that's the amount of interest. So if you were to borrow $5,000 at 5%, for 1 year, you'd have to pay back the $250 plus the $5,000 you borrowed, but you'd have interest of $250. So give the next one a shot, see what you get. Hit pause now. So you should have gotten $120. This is pretty simple, right? That's why it's simple interest. All right, a little bit different here. Let's just say that Jimbo invests X dollars. So now we don't really know what he's going to invest. We're making a formula, but he's going to do it at 3%. So you get this. And we're only going to use one for the year because that's what we're always looking at is 1 year. So we would get 0.03x. You'd still do the exact same multiplication now, but with a variable. Okay, so try it for part B. Hit pause and give it a shot. And there you go. That's the amount of interest you should have. All right, so that's a simple interest formula, and that's how you use it. You just plug in your interest rate and your principal. This will always be one, so from now on, we can just ignore the one. We don't have to even put it in there because it's always going to be one for our problems. And once you plug them in, you multiply, and it gives us our simple interest. Okay, so now this is part two. So if you have two different accounts, this is account one, this is account two, and you put in 4,000 in one account, 3,000 in the other account, that means you have a total of $7,000. That's it. So going in reverse, if you know that you have $11,000 to invest, if you put 5,000 in one account, then that would leave you with $6,000 because you're taking the 11,000 and you're subtracting $5,000. It's always that amount. Okay? So let's just say that this was X and that's 11,000. Then this would always be 11,000 minus X. It's just a way to set it up each time. So now you know you can just subtract them. And if you don't know this value, you know you can just write it as x and then 11,000 minus x. All right, so let's put all this together into a problem. Sarah invests $3,000 in one account for 1 year at 4%. So this is the first one. That's account one. Her interest rate is 0.04. She's going to invest $3,000 for 1 year. So that would give us her interest of $120. Just to double check it, 0.04 times 3,000, 120. Okay. Next account, she's going to do an 8% at $5,000 for 1 year, which would give her $400. And again, just to double check it, 0.08 times 5,000, 400. And there you go. Okay, so that would give us a total investment of $8,000 and a total interest of 520. So let's just say that you wanted to find out what her effective interest rate was. What did she actually get as a rate? She put in 4 and she put in 8, which would be a mixture of the two. Now we don't have to find this. I just want to do it because we got an extra minute. So to find this rate, it's just a percentage. On each rate, if you were to take the 120 for the first one, that's our first interest, divided by the 3,000, you get 4%. It's going to work for all of them. So 400 divided by 5,000, 8%. So if you want to find out what she actually got in interest rate combined, you take the 520, divide it by 8,000, and there it is, 6.5%. These will never add up. The interest rate that you're going to get for the final one will always be the combination of the two. It's an in-between value, right? It's not, it's basically you're getting a low of 4, a high of 8, so together you're getting somewhere in between, 6.5. And if you were to multiply that, you would see it works. This is why we use tables. Obviously going to work because we divided, but 520. And there it is. So that's our formula. These two will always add up to that. These two will always add up to this. And that's simple interest. If you have two different accounts, this is how you can do everything that we have. All right, thank you.